Got me shooting moon clips today. But instead of using the steel ones, which I carry, sometimes I practice, I use these rims. They're synthetic. I don't like to carry them because I don't trust them if you drop them and stuff. I mean, some people say they work, but I like the metal ones. But for practice, these are nice because you can load them by hand, in and out. You need tools to do it without hurting yourself with the steel ones. So for practice, these are nice. A little few of these, throw them in your pockets, and you're ready to go. Rims, synthetic ones, instead of the steel. Yeah, this is all double action shooting with the Smith & Wesson 325, which shoots, like I said, moon clips, or if you want, you have auto rims, which you can load directly. Buffalo bore auto rims. So that's another one, smooth double action. Right now, speed is not as important as the smoothness. I'm specifically training for smooth movements, control, recoil, smooth motions at the moment. That will change. Okay, today it's almost 100 degrees with the heat index, super humid and hot. So this will be a short session. And basically be working on the rhythm of shooting. You know, I'm going to be just pulling from the holster. And the rhythm of shooting, double action, recovering from recoil, and moving while shooting. So it's a simple draw. Depends on what range I'm at. At this range, I probably would go to two hands. As I get closer, I go to one hand. That way I can use, when I'm real close, I like to be able to fight, push off, shoot, and everything else. So if in this range, I'll go two hand. This is the rhythm of shooting. I'm not even worried about where I'm hitting, as long as it's in the target. I'm just getting to feel the rhythm in the holster. Just practicing there. The rhythm of shooting. Draw and fire smoothly as soon as you get it up. Okay, this time, the same thing. Drawing and moving and shooting. Same thing. I'm doing all headshots at the moment. Draw smooth as you're moving. Rhythm of shooting. You just want it smooth. You're not going super fast. I'm just getting the smoothness out. Moving and shooting. Now basically in the headshots, you know, all the group's reasonable, threw one out, but the rhythm's more important to practice there. Yeah, the 325 is a scandium gun, so it's really light. So its recoil is more than a heavier gun would be. So when I pull it up double action, as you're controlling the draw, you went smooth, you recoil, and you recover. As you recover, draw, recoil. As you recover, pull the trigger. It's the timing, the smoothness. You know, I'm always drilling at high speed like most people. But if you did it all the time, and you get a little bit rusty with your smoothness, your balance, your stability, then you develop bad habits. For this thing, this time we're gonna do same thing. Smooth, draw, double action pull, single action if I was using a semi-auto, of course, and motion. This time I'm closer, I'm simulating the guy pulls a knife. So as I'm drawing, because I'm closer, and shooting, I'm going to be putting space between me and him. Going backwards while smoothly drawing, shooting, and controlling the gun. Okay, let's do that again. You got to have good balance when you're moving. Nice smooth draw, trigger control. Alrighty. Okay, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to back up about an angle this time. Draw smooth, maintain good movements, control your trigger, control your sights. Same thing, opposite direction. Smooth draw, smooth movements. Okay, this time we're gonna do the same thing. Straight back again. Smooth. There you go, looking good. Another thing I like to do every so often, haven't done it very much lately, is approach the target and zigzag as you approach. So you practice your footwork and your gun control while you're moving. That way you have to maintain balance, good motion, and good gun control. Your last one, we're gonna do the same thing backwards. If you don't feel confident in doing this, don't do it. You don't want to trip and shoot yourself. You do it with a dry fire gun, no ammo, so you get used to it. Move backwards as you're changing directions while you're maintaining your trigger control, sight picture, and shooting. Alrighty.
What? Yeah, my 325, I got two custom holsters, both made by Andrew's Leather. And holsters are really a key thing. Today I was again shooting a Second Amendment ammunition, locally made ammunition. Great stuff, the only stuff you can find around here anymore. Can't even find stuff at Walmart, not even 22s. This is my Inside the Pants Andrew's holster. You'll notice it has a metal support band around the top to keep it open when it's inside your pants and you reholster it. Well, the previous holster, the belt holster, I had the same thing done to it. It was my own custom design that he put on there for me so I can reholster it just like the inside the pants. Works out very well.